Here we go.
So understand this verse. When the Bible talks about the heart, it's not talking about the vessel in your chest. It's talking about your mind. Decisions are made with your mind, not the vessel in your chest. Read on. Adultery. So inside your heart is what? Adultery. Read on.
Fornication.
Fornication.
Murders.
Murder.
Thefts.
Thefts.
Covetousness.
Covetousness.
Wickedness.
Wickedness.
Deceit.
Deceit.
Lasciviousness.
Lasciviousness.
An evil eye.
An evil eye.
Blasphemy.
Blasphemy.
Pride.
Pride.
Foolishness.
Foolishness.
That's all that's inside our heart.
That's good.
So when you say God knows my heart, you're a liar. God do know your heart, that you're wicked and that you don't want to do what he say do. According to the Bible, you so-called blacks are Israelites. You're the greatest thing that ever stepped foot on the earth, sisters. And you don't heard it today, you're Israelites. You ain't never been black or African-American. The words don't mean anything. We need to lift our spirits up with the words of the Most High God. Because being black ain't got us no damn well, and it don't mean nothing. Being African-American, Latino, Hispanic, ain't got us nowhere and don't mean a damn thing. Only what God says matter, brothers and sisters.
That's right.
Only what you do for God is what's gonna matter. And we can prove that with the Holy Scriptures. We can prove that. Read on.
All these evil things come from within and defile the man.
So should not one brother or sister ever say, well, God knows my heart. Yes, God do know your heart and that you are no damn good. What you gotta do is repent, learn God's laws and ways, and keep his commandments. And keep his commandments. That's what this thing boils down to, as the keeping of God's commandments in Christ. Why do you think we were slaves, brothers, sisters? Why was such a brutal slavery placed on so-called blacks and Latinos? Because we broke God's commandments, brothers and sisters. Sisters, y'all are Israelites according to the Bible. The greatest thing that ever touched the ground. The greatest. Lift your spirits up. I know we in the ghetto. I live in the ghetto too.
That's right.
I'm tired of the conditions of the community as well.
That's right.
But I know that the reason why our communities look this way is because we are continuing to disrespect the Most High God. That with the Bible and historical facts.
That's right.
We ain't never been none of them filthy names put on us during slavery. None of it. The slave master called you black.
That's right.
The slave master called you Latino, Puerto Rican, Hispanic. The slave master called you Negroes, Haitians, Jamaicans, Mexicans. But you gotta wake up and repent. Return back to your nationality. Return back to your God. And return back to your laws. We have a custom and ways, brothers and sisters. Hip hop is not our heritage and customs. Being a hoe is not our custom and ways. Being a gangbanger is not our custom and ways.
That's right.
Selling drugs is evil. But our people are so damn destroyed, we support every nigga that sells drugs. Every wicked Negro that get on the CD and start talking about selling drugs, we bad at garbage. And you wonder why the damn communities are jacked up. You wonder why your damn house is getting broken to every damn second. You wonder why your daughters, your sons getting robbed and raped. It's because of the filth we allow in our communities. To hell with all them wicked rappers, wicked singers, video vixens. To hell with them. They ain't bringing nothing beneficial to our people. They're poisoning our people. They are images of poison. Read that verse again. Matter of fact, jump back to Ecclesiastes. Ecclesiastes 5. What we out here teaching is that you so-called blacks are the Israelites. You so-called Latinos. You so-called Native Indians. You so-called Hispanics. You are the children of Israel.
That's right.
The sons and daughters of the Most High God. That's who you are. And we can prove that. Do our people love proof anymore? Is our people that damn stupid? We must be. It's time for us to wake up and repent. Wake up and repent. Read that again.
The book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 5, verse 5. Concerning propitiation, be not without fear to add sin unto sin.
Make sure you ain't adding sin on top of sin, brothers and sisters. And the only way you will stop from adding sin upon sin is to learn God's commandments. That's the way you stop adding sin on top of sin. Learning God's laws. Because sin is the breaking of God's laws.
That's right.
Covenant. It's a covenant between us and God.
This is a special day. Just like, let me relate it to something our brothers can relate to. Just like if you have a woman, the day y'all get together, what? It's a year from now, it's y'all anniversary. The Sabbath day is an anniversary between us and God every weekend. That is our special day with God. Just so you can realize it. Read the next verse.
It is a sign between me and the children.
Okay. What it is again, read it nice and slow. So I don't think I'm making this up.
It is a sign between me and the children of Israel.
It's a special day between us and God. Forever. Don't nobody have a God on the earth but us, brothers and sisters. Allah did never exist. Buddha never exists. Only the Lord God of Israel. Every nation on that, but us Negroes and Latinos don't know. We actually think Buddha was a real God. All these Greek gods, all these Egyptian gods. But they know there was only one true living God on the face of the earth. And there was evidence of that. That's why they made up God. We're the only one that got one God. Every nation got 1,000 gods, brother. And our people never acknowledge why is that. Because we are the ones that we are the people of the book. We are the sons and daughters of God. That's what Israel means. Princes and princesses of God. I think that's more powerful than African American. What you think? It's more better than West Indian, Haitian, Puerto Rican. That's who you are. Now, do what God called you to be more than what the white man called you with the whip and the chain? Because he beat black and African American on us. He beat colored and Negro on us. Those are his names for the children of Israel. But this is the name that God gave us. Can we come back to what God said? Or do what Master say mean more? Read that last verse again, verse 17, we don't jump.
It is a sign between me and the children of Israel forever. For in 6 days the Lord made heaven and earth. And on the seventh day he rested.
Even God rested on the seventh day. Even God. Us being his children, we must do the same. Jump to the book of Exodus. Make sure I got things right the way. Chapter 28, verse 8 through 11. You got any questions, bro? You just listen. Okay. You have to see another brother that understands who he is. A lot of our people walk past and care less about being an Israelite.
Here we go.